Greetings, friends and Robloxians. Welcome to a Little Kingdom production. Here we are in the Little Kingdom. Halloween update's over, thank goodness. I'm still sprucing up and taking down some of the scary stuff like the spawn point of brimstone and fire, trying to make the place a little more cheery. I moved the Eye of Sauron off the castle and replaced it with the Galaxian. I love it. So we have another new update. Was a surprise to me. It's a cooking update. Some very cool items were just added to the game. New food items you can craft, like sushi. Those items and some others now have very cool status effects. We're going to look closer at those. There's pond planters to grow rice and seaweed, so we'll have to get those new crops. There's a new icon for us to open to see the status of ongoing quests that the NPC vendor gives us. That's handy. We have a new cutting board workbench. We're going to have to get that. I love cooking. I was actually thinking about doing a little video tutorial series on auto farms and AFK food factories to make millions of coins. So now I make my way to my workbench and I'm going to find under workbenches the new cutting table. Let's see, where is it? Of course, it's the last one here. So we craft that. It takes 50 wood and 50 iron. Now I just need to clear a spot to place it and let's see what's inside. So we have tuna. I have no tuna. We've got cut eel, cut red snapper, and cut salmon. Looks like I'm going to be fishing in the near future. On the cooking table, now we have tomato soup that gives us an added 20% break speed, as if the pickaxe wasn't already fast enough. Oh no, all those ghosted stones I make. The jam sandwich gives an added 15% skill XP gain. That's going to be good for leveling up. Potato salad adds a 10% crop yield multiplier for those who want more berry bushes. That's excellent. The roast honey carrot gives a whopping 50% chance for mobs to drop coins when you kill them. For those who need coins, excellent. The candy apple adds 20% reward luck when fishing. We're going to need some of those soon. Orange honeycomb adds 30% chance to catch two fish at once. Eh, might be cool. Making candied fruits is a bit of a chore. Deviled eggs is another one that takes some work to craft, but it adds 25% drop for mining, so it might be worth it. I wonder how long those power-ups last. Truffle pizza adds 25% logging yield. Yield is just another way to say output or what's produced, so that's great. Now we have the sushi, and the dragon roll adds 25% more reward luck in combat. Add that to the rapier, and we're going to have an easy time getting those drops like pink stickies, rubies, and I don't know, I'll have to test that. I think actually I've had a dragon roll in real life before. The Philadelphia roll adds 25% fruit tree harvest. Can I feed that to my auto fruit tree picker machines? Can I put it in the petrol pipe? And the sushi roll, that's just what's needed to craft the other sushi items. This looks nice. Thai nigiri adds 10% output crafting foods. Okay, only 10%? Well, we'll take what we can get. And the tuna roll, last but not least, oh, it adds 5% coins when selling to the merchants. I probably won't use that, but I might sell them in vending if there's a demand for it. Now let's look at the ponds. These ponds are crafted on the workbench. They're not just useful for planting rice and seaweed, they're mandatory. So once you have rice and seaweed seeds, craft these and make your pond growing area. You purchase the rice seeds from Cletus in the hub. At 3,300 a seed, they're not cheap, but just start slow if you need to, buy a few. Seaweed's even harder to get because you have to fish for it. So this is where those candied apple power-ups would be handy. I did it the old-fashioned way. Well, I used bait and an iron fishing pole, which also increased fishing luck. I already got one seaweed seed. It only took me 40 minutes of fishing, and here's the moment when I reeled it in. I was really happy. That fishing is quite a chore. More fun to do with friends, but I was out here grinding alone. Well, mostly. I did meet this player, Snowing Ash, or Roblox Queen, so that was fun. I wish you all luck and happy power-ups. This is a great additive to the game. Please like and subscribe and comment. And remember, have fun and keep it imaginary.